budgets on television drama are challenged. There's never enough money to do everything everyone would want. And that's not a bad thing either, because it forces everybody to really think about exactly what they want to see. And I think that's a really good thing in the creative process, to have to think about every frame, because we're not making a massive movie where anyone can do anything they want. That's a bit simplistic view of the movie, but it is a different level of budget and it needs a different mindset.
How do you control your budget?
You just try and be as organised and prepped as possible and as open and communicative as possible. So on Jonathan Strange is a really fine example of when work can sort of be its best. I'm really proud of the work that we did, but the way in which we did it, I'd love to do that more often on jobs. It was a very, very creative collaboration, a sort of creative partnership from the very beginning right through to the end. It was very well organised, and that gives you a really high quality of work for the money and the time you've got to do it. In the book, Jonathan Strange conjures sand horses that run around on the beach for half an hour, and then the sailors on the boat lasso the horses, and then the horses tow them off the spit of sand or whatever they got stuck on. That's probably not brilliant for a television drama, even though it reads wonderfully. Television drama has to become its own thing, and you know Peter's made this wonderful adaptation. And budgetarily, you know, you're going to fail epically if you have to have these things in shot for hours. Visual effects are quite expensive, especially when we talk about the numbers of people involved in creating them. So JC designed with Toby, JC being the visual effects supervisor, a way of keeping the essence of the story of what had been written in the book. And so came up with this idea that he would conjure up the sand horses and they would run at the boat and boom, knock it off with the force of them charging at it and knock the boat into safety. And I think he designed a sequence with 18 visual effects shots in. So working together, backwards and forwards, we come up with this scene. And I think we had 18 shots in and it was a budget buster. And we designed that ourselves, so that's a hashtag epic fail for us. But we managed to get that down to 8 shots, and it still feels epic, and it's still a big moment that's visually, I think, really impressive. But it goes to show you how much do you really need. You don't need 18 shots to tell that story, you need 8. And you can still have that wow moment in the show. And I think that's a experience of what feels right and what looks good, and working with the director and the editor to come up with a sequence that's affordable but still good.